Welcome to How to Yugioh Fundamentals Rules. I'm just going to really cover the most basic rules. There will be a part two in the future, so look out for that. And look out for fundamental videos if you're new to Yugioh and you want to just get clued up on how to play this game. Definitely these are fundamental rules that I'm going to make are going to really help you and make you into, I hope, a Yugioh master. So let me start. Rule number one. The turn player does not draw a card. Now, what do I mean by this? First of all, to understand the turn player, we need to understand how this all comes about in the first place. So to determine who starts first in a typical game of Yu-Gi-Oh, it's either by a coin toss, or you know, you can play rock, paper, scissors, however you want to determine who goes first. When is determined that player who is going first in that game or in any game play of Yu-Gi-Oh, whether it is online or in real life, your turn player will not get to draw a card. Now we'll talk about the second rule of Yu-Gi-Oh, and that is to do with field spells. Field spells in Yu-Gi-Oh can only be activated and placed in the field spell console on the gameplay mat. Alright, that was pretty obvious. But here. Here's the real rule about it. The real rule about field spells, it comes down to two other rules, but one of the rules in regarding field spells is that field spells, let's say for example, I player one, which is me, activates a field spell. If player two activates a field spell as well, we'll call him, you know, player two. Player two's field spell will not destroy player one, my field spell that I just activated. So field spells that have been activated are not destroyed upon destruction with another activation or another field spell by your opponent. That's one of the first rules. One of the second rules as well is that field spells before used to affect the entire field, hence the name field spells, obviously. But with the current rule change that we've had recently over the years, field spells now only affect the turn player that activated them. So if player 1, which is me, activates a field spell, the benefits of that field spell will only apply to me, to myself. Same goes with player 2. If player 2 activates a field spell, the benefits of that field spell will only apply to player 2 and not to me. So bear this in mind with the role of field spells in Yu-Gi-Oh. And now we shall go to rule number three. This is to do with the Exodex Zone. The Exodex Zone is a new zone that has been introduced in 2017. It was introduced with a new summoning mechanic known as Lynx. Lynx? Lynx monsters are the new Exodex Zone mechanic that has been introduced by Konami in 2017. And so, with that release of the new summoning mechanic known as Lynx, they introduced a new zone on our gameplay mat known as the Exodex Zone. The Exodex Zone is where you place all your Exodex monsters on your new gameplay mat, which will have the Exodex Zone above the monster named Monster Zones. There are two Exodex Zones on the new gameplay mat. One is for you, the other is for your opponent. Now remember, the extra deck monster zone is where you replace your extra deck monsters. So any monster that you summon from your extra deck in Yu-Gi-Oh now, you will have to place it in the extra deck monster zone. Remember this when you play Yu-Gi-Oh! As of 2017 in any official way. If you're playing it for fun, maybe you want to play it with older rules, then you can get a previous match from a previous generation. But if you are playing current and modern Yu-Gi-Oh! going to current events, tournaments, you know, etc. Any of those kind of official things Yugioh related from 2017 onwards, you are going to need to get yourself a Yu-Gi-Oh, a current Yu-Gi-Oh playmat. So bear this in mind. And with that, I think I have covered all the basic rules in Yu-Gi-Oh so far. I will extend this to have a Yu-Gi-Oh Fundamentals Part 2, where we'll go in detail on other rules that you will find in Yu-Gi-Oh. But there's one other thing I would like to say. You are one step closer to becoming a Yu-Gi-Oh Master. My fate is in your hands. Like and subscribe. Hit and subscribe. You could decide to not subscribe at all. Your choice is yours. Goodbye.